Hello, in this video I will demonstrate how to compute the mean, variance, and standard deviation for group data. So let's assume that you are provided with the following problem. You have a group data frequency distribution, and you need to find the mean, modal class, variance, and standard deviation. So the first step is we have to add three columns to this table. You need a midpoint column. You need a frequency times a midpoint column. And you need a frequency times midpoint squared column. So let's extend these out a bit. To extend your Excel, your cells, you can just sort of click at the top and drag out each column. Let's now compute the midpoints. So to compute your midpoints, remember you have to add the two endpoints, in this case of the class boundaries, divide by two. We will do this by simply typing in the numbers and adding them together. So we type in the following. You put equals, parentheses, 59.5 plus 190.5, close the parentheses, divide by two. 125 is the first midpoint. We could repeat that by typing in the values for all the others, but let's determine the class width. That's going to help us in terms of adding the class width to each midpoint in order to generate the others. So we have the class width. Well, to find the class width, we just take the two adjacent lower limits and subtract them. So 190.5 minus 59.5, that's 131. So the class width for this group frequency distribution is 131. What that tells us is that we will simply add 131 to each level of our table in order to generate our midpoint. So it can easily be done by Excel using a function. So we type equals, we click on the cell that contains the very first midpoint, and we just put plus 131. And so that will add 131 to that very first midpoint in cell N12. And so we have our second midpoint. Now that we've established that function, all we have to do is, if you see this little dot here on the lower right corner, we can either click on that dot or drag that dot, and that process of adding the class width will be repeated for all the other values. So you wait until it turns into a cross, your cursor turns into a cross, and you could double click like I did, and it just, Excel will automatically compute those values for you. So we have all the midpoints. Next step, we have to compute all the frequency times the midpoint. So we type in equals, we click on the cell that contains the first frequency, use the asterisk for multiplication, so that's going to tell the cell to multiply. Select the cell that contains the first midpoint, hit enter, and we have the product of F times XM. Once again, we can just see this little square in the lower right corner. Just make sure Excel turns into a cross, the cursor, and you just either drag down like I'm doing here, or you double click on it to get to generate all the other products of the frequency times the midpoints. Now, there are several ways of computing the last column. However, I'm just going to go ahead and multiply this column with this column, XM times F times XM. So once again, we click equals. That lets Excel know that you're going to build a function, and our function's very simple. We click on the first midpoint, type in the asterisk four times, click on the first of the products of F times XM, hit enter, and we get our value. Now, if you want to have commas that separate every three digits of your number, we can click here. It's called comma style. It's the thousand separator. However, I would just go ahead and click on decrease decimal. We don't need any decimals here for now. And now our numbers are look more appropriate in terms of reading. Let's go ahead and once again, let's double click, and all the other values are generated. I like to sort of close off each of these columns. It's just a matter of your own personal style, just to know that we have a beginning and ending. And to do this, I use, you have several options here for the borders. I just use the border that encases all the cells. So that's just purely optional. All right, so now what we need is we need to find the sum of three columns. To do this, we will use the autosum feature. So we need the sum of the frequency column. That's going to be 31. Let me just go ahead and highlight these cells to ensure that the font size is readable. So 31. And I will just select those two columns and hit the autosum. Hit the autosum, and we have the sum of the F times XM column and the sum of the F times XM squared column. Now we're ready to compute the mean. So remember, for group data, the mean, once again, let me just go back and change the font size so we can be able to read our answers. The mean, we type in equals. That lets us know we're going to build a function. The mean is the sum of the F times XM column divided by the sum of the frequency, so 31. Hit enter. We have the mean. Let's round to the tenths. So we will round to the tenths. That's going to be 323.6. So the mean of your data set is 323.6. The modal class, that's just the class with the highest frequency. So 12 is the highest frequency. So 190, we'll type this in, 190.5 to 321.5 is the modal class. And let's double click to create some space for the modal class. Now the variance requires a little bit of effort because it's a more complex formula. So just try to follow these steps, but using the cells that are in your location in your table. So just the cells I will be using is P18, O18, and M18. Those cells may be different on your table depending on where you type your table in, if you're working a problem out similar to this. So what I do is I just click equals, and I automatically put two parentheses here. Okay, so that's kind of just to help organize the result. So the first parentheses is just for the entire variance. The second is for the numerator. So remember, the numerator is your n, in this case 31, times the sum of the last column minus the sum of the F times XM column squared. Now, to type a power in, we use the caret symbol. To type in the caret symbol, you type in shift 6, and that gives you the caret symbol, and then you put your power 2. Now, we close the parentheses. That's the numerator of your formula, divided by. What I just do at the bottom is, once again, I put another set of parentheses, And remember, we have, I'm just going to type in n. N is, in this case, 31. Like I said, it'll be different on your table most likely. But in this example, it's 31. And then we need times. So asterisk, 31 minus 1. Well, 31 minus 1 is 30. Then we close the parentheses, and then we close it one more time. We hit enter, and we get the variance. 41,038.78. Finally, to compute the standard deviation, Excel has a built-in square root function. We type equals SQR, and right away you can see that Excel is listing some of its built-in functions. We need SQRT parentheses, and we just click on the variance, because that cell, M22, is what contains the variance. The standard deviation is the square root of the variance. Close the parentheses, hit enter. We have, let's go to the tens on both of these. We now have these, the mean 323.6, the modal class 190.5 to 321.5, variance 41,038.8. Standard deviation 202.6. Thank you very much. We are now complete with that problem.